One of the things we know about climate change is our projections are improving. That myth that we can't predict future climate, that's going away. Our models are pretty good. So in terms of rainfall, we know that we'll see more intense rainstorms in the wet parts of the regions. For example, when it rains heavily, it's raining with more intensity than it did 30, 40, 50 years ago. So the 2020 rainstorm is not the same as the 1970s rainstorm. Why that's important is that our engineered system in cities and coastal regions aren't designed for this new generation of rainstorms. In terms of hurricanes, the scientific literature suggests that while we may not see more hurricanes, when we do see them, on average, they will be stronger and they are likely to intensify more rapidly. And in some cases, as we saw with Hurricane Harvey and Floyd and Florence, I should say, they slow down and stall, and that leads to even more rain. You think about Hurricane Harvey, 50 inches of rain in over a week. And so that exacerbates the flood threat. These are concerns that we have for the coastal region. In terms of sea level rise, this is one of the things that really concerns me. Our projections told us that sea level is going to rise, but sea level rise is one of those things like Arctic sea ice that's changing more rapidly than we even projected. And so I'm quite concerned that we need to bring our infrastructure and our preparedness up to those rates that we're seeing in terms of sea level rise.
It's important to plan for sea level rise in our communities because we have a lot of our infrastructure that is in the way of where the water will be coming. It also gets people out of harm's way for future flooding, whether that's sea level rise or storm surge. So it's really important for us to go ahead and consider that now. We'll spend a lot less now than in the future. So recently, one of the communities that has taken some steps to mitigate for sea level rise, I would say here in Glenn County, they recently updated their zoning ordinances and increased the freeboard for building in the area. And that's a huge step. That is not a mandatory requirement by the state. That's solely an elective step that the county has taken, and I applaud them for that.
By elevating a home, you do several things. Number one, you can keep the water out of your home. Number two, the elevation really helps in your flood insurance, how much the premiums are. And you know, number three, just makes the entire area more resilient. Water comes up, water goes down, and then you're back to being normal. Yeah, the CRS program is something that's put out by FEMA and the NFIP, which rewards a community for doing things the right way, by having outreach to the public, by documenting and creating ways to have more resiliency. They have a point system that communities can gain discounts on the flood insurance for their citizens. When a community plans well, that means they've looked into the future and they know that a structure is created safely. There's going to be savings on flood insurance. There's going to be savings due to the elevation of it, of the safety of it. And they know that that structure can be resold at a fair market value in the future without having to worry about the flooding around it.
It's important to think about the kids who are going to be impacted by sea level rise and the future generation. A lot of the resources could potentially go away if we don't better plan for habitat shifts and changes in our area. They could be paying more money than what we are even paying for right now to adapt and mitigate for sea level rise. And so offsetting the cost for future generations is really important. We have schools now that really are already being impacted by high tide flooding, and we know that that will only increase as sea level rises. And so really looking forward to the future generation being able to enjoy the resources that we have now.